Anna Thomas, and I'm a data and applied scientist on the Azure SQL team here at Microsoft. Today, I just want to record a quick video to show you how you can use Azure Data Studio to get connected to your Azure SQL databases. So let's dive in. Here, we're looking at Azure Data Studio. And if you haven't seen this before, it's really cool. I definitely recommend checking it out. But what you see is I've got some different options on this left-hand side. I have settings. I'm actually authenticated to Azure from here. And I can see my different server groups. So you can see I've organized them by what they are. So I've got my Azure SQL Database Edge, my SQL Server 2019 instance, and my Big Data Cluster instance. Now, I want to actually add a new connection. And so what we're gonna do is go ahead and connect to my Azure SQL Database instance. So I'm just going to put in the logical server here and go ahead and log in with my credentials. Oops. And remember my password. And now the server group, that's these different groups of colors that I have here. So I can actually go ahead and say add new group, and I'll add Azure SQL Database, and I'll give it a different color and hit OK. Now from there, I can name this if I want, or I can just leave it as the default, but I'll name it Wine Quality because that's what it is. Now when I hit connect, what I get is this create new firewall pop-up. So it's saying I don't have access to the server yet from this IP address, but because I'm authenticated, I can actually go ahead and add my client IP to the list of OK IP addresses. So I can hit OK, and this takes a few seconds, but once it runs, you can see I'm connected to my Wine Quality database. I can navigate the files that are within it, the tables in it, and do things like learn how to configure my dashboard, new queries, or even create new notebooks just from here. So I know that was a quick video. I hope it was useful for getting started with Azure Data Studio and your Azure SQL databases. Thanks for tuning in, and be sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and leave us a comment on what you're doing with Azure Data Studio. Thank you.